Okay, we will now go on to errors of GPS. Can you read the first one, please?
First one is atmospheric and thermospheric field.
Now, the electromagnetic waves which are being transmitted by the satellites, or what is called as radio waves, are coming through atmosphere to us. Ionosphere, troposphere is there. It actually gets, when it goes through, it gets basically an opposition. The velocity of the electromagnetic wave in space is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second, or rather in vacuum, right? But when it comes into atmosphere, it is facing an opposition, so the velocity gets reduced. It can also be in terms of refraction and all. Right now you can just take it as, since there is opposition, the wave's velocity gets reduced, though very marginally, but it is good enough to give us an error in the fixes. So that is why it is ionospheric and tropospheric delay. A little delay is caused, speed is slightly reduced. As I said, very, very marginally, the error is not very high. It could be only a few meters, but it is there. That is the first one, ionospheric, tropospheric delay. What is the next one?
Second one is a user's clock error.
User's clock error is very simple. As I told you, your clock and the satellite clock, there is a mismatch because you are not using an atomic clock. Satellite is using an atomic clock, so there is bound to be a mismatch. That is user's clock error. In terms of delta T, here we are accounting for it, right? But only when either three satellites for shipping or for aeronautical and land lovers, four satellites are taken, then this error is calculated and applied, and hence it is gotten. So actually speaking, this error won't really make too much of an inaccuracy in the fix. It is calculated here, but however it is still there. It's one of the errors. Next.
What one is satellite clock error?
Now, satellite clock error, basically, as I said, the satellite is updating its time with reference to the master control, who is the ultimate reference system in the whole thing. The master control is the big boss. He is the one who has got the reference for the clocks. The error between that and the satellite clock is called a satellite clock error. That again is given to us basically in the navigation message. The first part of navigation message gives us the clock error or satellite clock error. So technically both these, the delta T in terms of user clock and the satellite clock, both these errors actually do not affect the accuracy of the position. They are calculated and applied. Okay? Yeah. What is next?
Geometrical dilution of precision.
Geometric dilution of precision. Now basically, you are aware, if you take visual bearings, let's say, and the angle between the two bearings is very small, that means, let's say, the angle is something like this. What will be the accuracy of this fix vis-a-vis if this is the angle? That means accuracy of this fix and accuracy of this fix, which one is better?
Perpendicular.
This one, right? That is, in terms of satellites, we take ranges. So ideally, if I'm taking four satellites, the ranges should be such that they have a very large cut. We can't say 90 degrees, but a very large cut. If they have a larger cut, they are more accurate. Now, how will the satellite find out which, or your receiver find out which satellites are going to give you a larger or a good cut for a fix? For that purpose, again in the navigation message, the fifth or the last subframe gives you the almanac of all the satellites. So it knows the position of all the satellites. It can choose the best suited to give you an ideal cut. That will reduce the error by GDOP, or geometric dilution of precision. Right? Now, having said this, generally, your receivers will give you a value of GDOP. The lower the value of GDOP, the higher is the positional accuracy. The higher the value of GDOP, the lower the positional accuracy. Is it clear what is GDOP?
Yes,
or geometric dilution of precision. Now sometimes the words come up like vertical dilution of precision and horizontal dilution of precision. Basically g dot is the error or total error. If I take the total error and I split it in the horizontal direction and in the vertical direction, then the error component in horizontal direction will be called as h dot, or horizontal dilution of precision component in the vertical direction will be called as v dot, or vertical dilution of precision. Obviously v dot will affect your latitude, g dot will affect your h dot will affect your longitude. H dot, v dot and g dot is the resultant of the two. Clear? In terms of aeronauticals, there will be a third dimension which we call as altitude, that could also have errors, and if that has errors, then again it is one more component. Just remember, when we talk in two dimensions for shipping, latitude and longitude, for aeronautical it will always be three dimension. And if you look at this corner of this room here, there is one dimension going along this way, one dimension here, one dimension on top. And if I take this point here, top of this, and I draw a line from there here, I can split that up into three components, 1, 2, 3, right? Basically, the direct line joining from here to the center and then splitting into components. I'm not going into resolution of vectors, that's not our subject, but just you need to understand, because sometimes questions will come up, what is H top and what is V top? Basically, they are components of G top. Clear or any doubts?
Clear.
What is next?
Multipath error.
Multipath error. What is multipath error now? Basically, the satellite signals should actually come directly to your antenna. Let's say this is your GPS antenna, satellite signals should come directly. What are the chances that the satellite signal may be hitting some other antenna or the hull of the ship or some railing or something, funnel of the ship for that matter, and then coming here? So one coming directly, one others coming different directions. All that will get coupled, frequency is the same, time difference is not too much, that could give you an error, that is called as multipath error. Anything else?
Last one, deviation of satellite from the predicted
path. Deviation of satellite from the predicted path. Now, as I told you, the upload station gives the data to the satellite 3 times in 24 hours. That's the minimum. Now, suppose the data has come to the satellite at 1200 hours. You are taking a position at 1600 hours with that satellite. The question is, from 12 to 1600 hours, how has the satellite moved? Has it moved as per the predicted path, or is it slightly away? Because as I told you, gravitational pull from satellite to satellite will also be there with other satellites and with respect to surface of the earth or the center of the earth. So there can be some variation in the path, though it is all this is predicted very accurately. However, prediction is a prediction, it cannot be absolutely accurate. And in terms of atomic clocks, we are talking of 1 into 10 raised to minus 11, as I told you, being the accuracy of the atomic clock. So obviously there will be some deviation, that is what is deviation from the predicted path. Clear or any doubts, anybody? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay then, thank you.